against Larry Michon in District 8. So, Ron, good. I'll let you take over. Do your thing.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Coming here today is sort of like coming home. I represented Clay County and Sullivan County many years ago in the legislature. When I was waiting to be admitted to the bar, I worked up here in a law office. I start off all the time by asking people in a meeting like this, has Dr. Michon made your life better? If not, vote for Ron Drake. But today, I would say, have Republicans made your life better? If not, vote for the Democratic ticket, because you know that the Democratic ticket will make your life a whole lot better. I'm a former teacher. It gives me great pleasure to introduce to you our current superintendent of instruction. That's what I remember that as well. Who will be our next superintendent, Glenda Rich.
Isn't that fabulous? And I think it Brazil, the values of Terre Haute, the values of Sanborn, back to not only State House, but also all the way to Washington, D.C. Yeah. I'm here for my husband, Evan Bai, who's meeting with the Farm Bureau, and I met some farmers here, so they know how important it is that he do that. I also want to thank our friends in the UAW that are here, because they are just fantastic. Here to Indiana. And I know many of you work up just up the road in Greencastle in the auto parts industry. And I want to tell you what you need to tell your fellow workers and tell your friends that work with the UAW and work in the auto industry. That when they were in trouble, Evan Bai reached across the aisle, got Dick Lugar to vote with him, and they voted for the auto rescue. And you have to know those car companies paid every penny back. But because those two men worked together, Democrats and Republicans, 100,000 families in our state had a good job. Yeah. Also, look at what's happening with the Carrier Corporation in Indianapolis. It's just so sad. 1,400 families that are going to lose jobs to Mexico. We need John Gregg as our governor to make sure those jobs don't leave. We also need that. That company, Carrier, who was profitable in Indianapolis but moved those jobs to Mexico, is able to write off the costs of moving all of our jobs to Mexico. That's just not right. We need a senator who's going to stand up for Indiana workers, who's going to stand against those corporations that are moving those jobs overseas, who wants to make sure that we have fair trade, not free trade. Very, very important. My husband has come out opposed to the TPP. He's a person who very much cares about Indiana workers. You know, when he was governor in the state, we had wonderful state employees unions as well as UAW support. We need a senator that's willing to stand up for Indiana workers. Can you help me elect Evan Bai? The first one is very important. I don't see that many college kids are probably studying, we hope, right? Or not going to a Halloween party. But we have so many college students that are in our state right now, and you guys have tried to send your kids to college. It's expensive. It's extremely expensive. That's why Evan, with John Gregg's help, started something called the 21st Century Scholars. I don't know if anybody's been able to take advantage of that program, but it's a wonderful program. It sent 70,000 kids, tuition-free, to college in the state of Indiana. They're going to graduate without all that student loan. John Gregg in Indiana and Evan Bai in Indiana have already done it. 70,000 kids. I also want to make sure that we have a senator who stands up to protect Social Security. There are people in the Congress, including our opponent, that like to privatize it. They call it a Ponzi scheme. They call Medicare welfare. This is just wrong. This is a sacred pact that our older citizens have made with the federal government, and y'all depend upon it. I'm dependent upon it. We want to make sure that it's there for everybody to depend upon. It's a contract that you make. We need a senator who's willing to stand up to keep Social Security, to make sure those premiums for Medicare are low, to make sure prescription drug prices are low, and make sure the pact we've made with Indiana seniors stays strong for years to come. Will you help me elect that? Back as well. Indiana. She's a breath of fresh air. She's a very intelligent woman who's going to work for Indiana families, Indiana workers, and make sure that our government works for you. I want to introduce Christina Hale. Jobs, and I'll tell you something else. John Gregg and I are not auditioning for different jobs. We want to be your governor and lieutenant governor. John Gregg and I have a plan. John has cast a strategic vision for our state, and we have a plan to carry it out. That's the biggest difference between ourselves and our opponent, and the biggest difference between John and Eric Holcomb. Eric Holcomb was once called the nastiest campaigner in the state of Indiana. John Gregg received a national award from Governing Magazine because he collaborated with Brian Bosma to save Indiana when we suffered the tragedy after 9/11, huge economic impact on our state. They got together, came up with a plan, and it worked. And the nation saw that, and they were recognized for it. John Gregg is a working man. He's the first man in his family to graduate from college. And graduate school, and law school. And he put himself through school. He worked hard. He's been a single dad, so he knows how to hustle to get things done. And he knows how difficult it can be to be a family here in Indiana. He knows, and it's beyond time for us to put someone in our state house that really gets what it's like to live in Indiana, someone that was not born with a silver spoon in his mouth. He's got calloused hands because he works hard. And I bet many of you in this room were shaking those hands. I'm so proud of him. I'm so very proud of him. He has met a payroll. He's been an executive at a Fortune 500 company. And he served our state as Speaker of the House. He's also served as President of a university. I think we've got a pretty quality candidate. John Gregg.
Bingo's one of them.
best visit ever to a bingo hall. Brian, I worked at Amex Home years ago together, and I'm glad that he's mayor here in town. But we need some other help. We need some legislators in Indianapolis, and we've got three of them here today that want to help us: Tim Fiddler, Bill Green, and Tim Skinner. Substance, talking about issues that Hoosiers want to hear about. We've talked to hundreds of people across the state of Indiana to talk about the economy, to talk about education, to talk about infrastructure, to talk about our drug crisis, to talk about the environment, to talk about how to make voting easier, talk about civil rights, talk about how we get more businesses in Indiana and how we help those that are here. That's what this election is about. It's about bringing people together. It's about finding some common ground, taking the best ideas from Democrats and Republicans and independents and moving us forward. And we can do that. Now, I want to tell you, the last couple of days have been pretty heady in this campaign. We have raised, because of men and women like you all across the state, $16.5 million to run in this campaign. And to tell you how much that means, that's how we've been on television for the last 8 months. And it started with, I'm going to tell you a story. Because when you tell a figure like that, people say, oh my land. Now remember, when we advertise on television in Indiana, we got to advertise in Louisville, Evansville, Terre Haute, Indianapolis, Lafayette, Fort Wayne, South Bend, and the real cheap area, Chicago. We've been able to be on all those stations since May 5th because of men and women like you. One day I came home from work in May of last year, and Lisa opened up, had a letter she'd already opened up and read. She says, you've got to see this. And I looked at the letter, it had one of those gum labels, you know what, the free ones you get where you're supposed to send money in, and had a name in there. It said, Claude Johnson, Crawfordsville, Indiana. And I could tell by looking at the way it was written that Claude had probably 20 years or more on me. You can tell sometimes by the handwriting. And she said, you gotta read the letter. Open it up, and it said, Dear Mr. Gregg, I've lived in Montgomery County all my life. Our state's hurting. Our reputation has suffered. Our communities are crumbling, and our schools are in chaos. We can't stand four more years of this Pence Holcomb administration. I'm retired, and I'd like to send you $500, but I can't. I'm going to send you $10 this week, and maybe next week I can send you some, and between now and a year and a half from now, maybe I can get you to $500. And I'll tell you why, Claude Johnson sent over $600. $10. Talking issues, and we are so proud that yesterday, with all this momentum going on, with the money we've raised. And one reason why we raise so much more is because we've got Republicans and independents supporting us. There are good Republicans out there that don't agree with their party and are asking and supporting us. And I'm asking you to reach out and talk to some of them and see if you can get them to vote for us. Can I get you to do that in the next few days? Yes. I'm going to tell you, the day we do the record is the day the war on organized labor stops. And I want to thank the members of United Auto Workers for being here. I want to thank Joe Breedlove, who's a former Secretary Treasurer of the State AFL-CIO, who's here with us today. We are proud to have received the endorsement of over 10,000 Fraternal Order of Police members in the state of Indiana. And their executive director is here, a friend of mine from law school, a former law enforcement officer. Give a big Southern Indiana welcome to Leo Blackwell. has ever endorsed a Democrat. What do you think about that?
Yeah.
We've got school teachers. We've got your community school teachers. We've got working men and women. We've got law enforcement. And I woke up yesterday to find out that the Terre Haute Tribune Star endorses. The Evansville Courier Press endorses. The Prince of Fort Wayne. You've got to go back to the 1960s before this happened. But if you're a Hoosier, you know there's a major paper in this state that normally doesn't take much of cotton with the Democrats. It's called the Indianapolis Star. And yesterday, hang on to your seats, if you didn't know it, the first Democrat non-incumbent they've endorsed since the 1960s, John Gregg and Christina Hayes. Teaching to the test and using teachers as the solution, not as the problem. Working with Glenda Ritz, focusing on good paying jobs like the auto workers and the construction trades. We're going to talk about a real infrastructure program. Are you tired of your roads and bridges? Don't blame your mayor, blame the legislature, actually blame the governor, because he's the one that comes up with that poor plan we've got. Don't you think we deserve better in Indiana? Yes. Yes. But everybody in this room's got to vote, your family's got to vote, and you're going to talk to four more people, and you're going to tell them what's important about this election. I am so honored to be here with you today. I spent a lot of great years here in Clay County many years ago when I worked at Amax Coal. If those of you are natives for many years, a lot of you natives in this, everybody from Staunton, anybody in here from Staunton? I was friends for many years with Mel Lucas. Do you remember Mel Lucas? Since passed away. But thank you all very much. It's great.